Hello, YouTube and fellow DC comic fans. I'm Keith OneShot, and this is my Comic Complete Dramatic Reading Series. And today, we will be covering Batman, Issue 25, The War of Jokes and Riddles, from DC Rebirth. All art, text, characters, and storylines belong to DC Comics and their respective owners, not me. If you enjoyed this story, feel free to go out and support DC Comics and your local comic book shops. We start this issue off with a comedian on a dark stage. The spotlight is on him and he's trying his best to stay alive out there as his jokes are failing to deliver the punchline. While this is happening, Batman is also narrating.
After it was all over, I tried to see how it all began. I went where they had gone. If there were recordings, I watched the recordings. If there were witnesses, I interviewed the witnesses. If there was evidence, I collected the evidence. When I found all that I could find, I visited each of them in turn. I talked to them in their cells. I spoke to them across the bars. They told me their stories. Some of it was true. In the end, I knew everything there was to know. Or at least, I knew every fact there was to know. What happened? What motivated them? What motivated me? Whether I knew that or understood that, I don't. All I can do is tell the story and let you decide.
The comedian on the stage is bombing his audition so terribly that the man watching him stands up and says, "Enough!" The comedian begs the man for one more chance to tell a great joke, the comedian telling the man, "I swear, it's good! You'll love it! It kills!" And sure enough, it does kill, as the man fires the pistol, giving off a loud bang! And just like that, the would-be comedian is dead. The man then says, "Next, please!" As the second comedian comes to the stage, he says, I'm Chris Fetta from Queens. And the man in the dark says to him,
"Yes, yes, don't forget to clean up the stage. Alright, go ahead, Mr. Fetta, I'm ready to laugh."
We then jump over to the interrogation room of the GCPD, where an officer is interrogating a prisoner. The prisoner laughs. Ha 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 ha. Then the officer says to the prisoner, "I got 14 dead in Gotham here, Enigma, so excuse me, but I'm not seeing the joke." Turns out, the prisoner is none other than Edward Enigma, the Riddler. Enigma replies to the officer by saying, "No, I'm sorry. I know you don't, detective, but can't you at least see? That is the joke." Batman then narrates,
"Riddler had been locked up for almost a year. During that time, some cops in GCPD had begun using him. If they had a puzzle they couldn't solve, they went to him."
The officer is getting frustrated with Enigma, and he's about to leave. Then he says to Enigma, "Guess Gordon's right. Only the Bat can figure out where Joker's hiding." Then Enigma replies by saying,
"Wait, please. I can do it. I can help. I can solve it better than... anyway. If you can just clarify one thing, it'll be easier to solve."
The police officer then replies, "Sure, Enigma. What do you need?" The Riddler then tells the officer, "Well, if you could just, could you just tell me why the end of the world never comes?" The officer is confused by this, and he answers, "Excuse me?" Then suddenly, Enigma leaps forward at the officer with a knife in his hand as he violently stabs the officer and says to him the answer of his own question, "Because it's round!" Then we see the officer's dead body on the ground, Enigma standing over him as Batman narrates.
"The Riddler started in the lieutenant's neck, but it seems the knife hit a hard bone, frustrating him. So he moved on quickly to the stomach, then the chest, then back to the neck, the face, up, down, in, out. He stabbed the lieutenant 26 times, once for each letter of the alphabet. He said it was to show he had something to say, something he was trying to spell out."
We are then outside in the daytime at the Joke Factory, where the building is surrounded by GCPD officers, led by Commissioner Gordon. One officer tells Gordon,
"Team's ready! What's the call, Commish?"
Then Gordon tells the officer,
"Send them in now! Go, go, go!"
Then, as the officers make their way closer to the Joke Factory, there's a sudden loud BOOM! As the face of the building explodes, the officers then regroup behind their cars. Then Batman narrates,
"Before the start of it all, it felt to me like weather was a reaction, or a consequence. I was coming off my first year. I had fought the demons. I had warred on crime. I had done well. Gotham had been in the shadows for decades, and I came in, dug in my heels, put my shoulder on its steel, and I pushed. I pushed it into the light."
Outside of the Joke Factory, a man is pointing his gun at a police officer, who is knocked down from the explosion. The man kills the officer, and says to the officer's dead body, "A man walks into a bullet. Ouch. Isn't that funny? It should be funny. No, no, no." We then see that the man is the Joker, as he then shoots a woman, and says to the woman, "A woman walks into a bullet. No, no, no." Then the Joker walks away from the scene of the crime. Batman then narrates,
"I stood on a rooftop that very morning. As Joker was holding his auditions in the club, I looked out at the sun rising over the skyline. I felt the warmth of the coming dawn. I remember, I smiled. Then I went home and slept peacefully."
We then see the Riddler as he's making his escape. He is swarmed by GCPD SWAT members, who aim and point their guns at the Riddler and demand that he get on the ground. Then one SWAT member says to Enigma, "You have 3 seconds, then we drop you. 3, 2, then Enigma begins saying names. Joanna Elizabeth Sanchez, Lillian M. Langsford. One of the SWAT members then says, "That's my daughter's name." Then Enigma says more names, and another officer says,
Don't say another word! You don't get to say her name! But then the Riddler keeps saying more names, which is freaking out and scaring most of the SWAT members. And then one of them says to Nygma, "You come near my daughter!" Then Nygma says, "Ahem, when is it bad luck to see a black cat?" And as Nygma walks away, he says, "When you're a mouse." Batman then narrates, "Riddler made friends with a guard, Ronnie Barron. Started showing Ronnie how to bet on football games. Ronnie made quite a lot of money. When I talked to him, he didn't think there was anything wrong with it. It was money for his kids, for his daughter. Ronnie told me the Riddler never asked for anything that would help him in his escape. Not for a shovel or a knife. Nothing at all. All Riddler wanted was stories about the other guards. What they did on their off time. Where'd they live? Were they married? Did they have kids too?" We then see the Joker in the backseat of a taxicab, and the Joker says to the driver, "A man goes into a toy store and says he would like to buy a new boomerang, but he would also like to know how to throw the old one away." The taxicab driver then starts laughing and says, "Okay, that's pretty funny." Then suddenly a loud bang! The Joker shot the taxicab driver and says, "No, it's not." Then we see the taxicab go out of control without its driver as it crashes into a nearby fountain. Then the Joker stumbles out and shoots a man as he walks into a nearby building. Then Batman narrates, "He thought it might have been hilarious, after all this time, all the people he's murdered, all the people that want to murder him. Then one pretty night, for no reason at all, he breaks his own neck in the back of a car. It could have been hilarious, he could have just died laughing. The crash was reported in the police channels, I had an alert tied to that site, and was informed immediately. I got in the car, drove fast, I did all I could to get there as soon as I could, but the Riddler got there first."
We then see the Riddler walking into the same building that the Joker just did a moment ago, and the Riddler says, "Stop imagining. A man wishes to go into a nightclub, but he does not know the password required for entry. The man observes others being let in, talking to the doorman. The doorman says 12, the visitor says 6, let in. The doorman says 6, the visitor says 3, and is let in. The man now understands the pattern as he goes to the entrance. The doorman says 10, the man says 5. The man is turned away rudely. But why? The code is the number of letters in the word. 12 is 6, 6 is 3. 10, therefore, should also be 3. The Riddler makes his way through the building and into the Joker's penthouse apartment, and the Riddler says, "Knock, knock." The Joker then answers, "Who's there?" The Riddler then responds by saying, "An answer. But before we get to that, would you like to know how I knew the question? How I solved your puzzle? The puzzle you left for him? The pattern on the map? The nose on the clown face you were building? Then the joke for the location. Why did 6 fear 7? Because 7, 8, 9. But I didn't just see that. I saw everything. I know you can't laugh." The Joker begins to look increasingly more pissed off as the Riddler continues to say, "It was in the patterns. The way you were attacking Gotham. Stand-ups, joke shops, comedy movies, shows, looking for humor, all while drawing him to you. It's him, isn't it? Punchlines need to be unpredictable. That's why they're funny. But with him, now everything is predictable. You always lose." The Joker is just sitting there with his hands on his chin, letting the Riddler talk, as the Riddler goes on to say, "You need to laugh, or else who are you? And you can't laugh as long as he's out there. To laugh again, you'll need to kill him. What you don't know is, I feel the same way. Riddles, they're all after him now. They're all pathetic to me. I can solve anything, everything, but I can't solve him. And if there's a puzzle I can't solve, I need to solve the puzzle, or else who am I?" The Riddler then points at the Joker and tells him, "I was trapped inside that prison, willing to be trapped there forever. Then I saw you. I saw your plan, and I had to talk to you. I had to stop you. Think. If one of us does it, the other will forever be unsatisfied. I can't let you solve my puzzle. You can't let me tell your joke. I'd kill you before I'd let you kill him, and you'd try to kill me before I did the same. We'd go to war. We'd burn the city trying to stop the other from doing what we had to do. And worst of all, he lives. Neither of us finds a way out of his maze." Then, the Riddler looks at the Joker and says to him, "But there's a way out, friend. The path is obvious. The two of us. Jokes and riddles. We don't fight. We come together. We laugh together. We solve together. We kill the Batman." Then the Joker finally lets out a "hmm" as the Riddler leans closer to the Joker and says, "I can see all the moves. Everyone. It's what I do. And this is the only move that gets us out of this hell." The Joker is finally done listening, and he says to the Riddler, "Yes, you're right, together. It's the only way I'll laugh again. Or maybe, this will more." Then the Joker puts his gun to the Riddler's stomach and pulls the trigger. Bang! And the Riddler falls to the ground. The Joker says, "No, no, that didn't. That's not funny. Hmm." Then the Joker walks away and says, "And now with you. Well, if he comes, how will it play out? I don't know." Batman then narrates, "45 caliber from that distance? That much blood lost? No one survives that." Then we see Batman crash through the window into the Joker's penthouse apartment, where he finds the Riddler bleeding out on the ground, and the Riddler says to Batman, "He took my bomb! The Joker! He ran! He left with the bomb!" Then Batman narrates,
"That's why I left, because he wouldn't survive, and there were others who might. Alone now, he grabs his wounds. He squeezed it, and blood filled his hands, as if he were an old sponge. He later told me, dripping with water and soap, waiting to be wrung. And so while I chased the Joker, while I lost the Joker amongst the panic in the building, the Riddler too got away." And so it came. Over the next months, as I fought to hold the city together, Gotham divided, then fell into slaughter, misery, torture, mayhem, havoc, devastation, insanity.
We then see Bruce Wayne, and he says,
"People think they understand me. Alfred, Gordon, the boys, all of Gotham in its way. Even you, a man in pain trying to save who he can. They think, but they don't understand a damn thing about me."
We then see it's Selina Kyle, the Catwoman, who Bruce is laying down in bed with, as he's been talking to this whole time, and Bruce tells Selina,
"Because they don't know, Cat. They have no idea. You have no idea. But you have to before any of this. You have to know what I did, what I had to do during the War of Jokes and Riddles."
And that ends this issue of Batman issue 25, The War of Jokes and Riddles, part 1. Comic published by DC Comics. All rights, story art, and characters are owned by DC Comics and their respective owners. Not me. This has been Batman Rebirth, issue 25, The War of Jokes and Riddles, part 1. And I'm your host, Keith One-Shot. If you like this video, make sure to support DC Comics. Pick up a copy of the trades and single issue comics. Support your local comic book shop. Take care, and have a great day. Goodbye.